Hi, let's talk about laryngeal neurovasculature. In this video, we'll talk about the arteries and nerves which serve the larynx. So let's start with the vasculature. There are two vessels, two arteries, which are serving the larynx. There is the superior laryngeal artery and the inferior laryngeal artery. That superior laryngeal artery actually is going to be served by the superior thyroid artery. And we can see that superior laryngeal artery branching from the superior thyroid before accompanying the internal branch of superior laryngeal nerve through this hiatus in the thyrohyoid membrane. So here's the thyrohyoid membrane. That superior thyroid artery is a branch of the external carotid artery. The inferior laryngeal artery is a branch of the inferior thyroid artery. That inferior thyroid artery comes from the thyrocervical trunk. So thyrocervical trunk comes from the first part of the subclavian artery. So first part of subclavian artery, to thyrocervical trunk, to inferior thyroid artery, to inferior laryngeal artery. That inferior laryngeal artery ascends in the tracheoesophageal groove along with the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So let's take a look at the nerves which are serving the larynx. Just to point out the lay of the land here, some of these muscles that are associated with the larynx posteriorly. Here we have the middle pharyngeal constrictor. Middle pharyngeal constrictor is associated with the hyoid bone. And then below that, we have the inferior pharyngeal constrictor. And as you recall, the inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle has two parts. There's the thyropharyngeal part, and then the cricopharyngeal part. The thyropharyngeal part is associated with the thyroid cartilage. Cricopharyngeal part is associated with the cricoid cartilage. And these are going to have some relevance to these nerves. So let's start up here. So the superior laryngeal nerve is a branch of the vagus nerve, cranial nerve 10. And it ramifies into the internal branch, which goes through this hiatus, to innervate the mucosa superior to the vocal folds. And that's going to have two functions. One, it will be afferent from those mucosae. And two, it will be secretomotor to the glands of those mucosae. Everything above the vocal fold. So the vocal folds would be approximately there. The other branch of superior laryngeal nerve is the external branch, which we can see descending down here. And the external branch is the oddball in terms of the intrinsic laryngeal muscles, because that is going to innervate the cricothyroid muscle to elevate pitch. That external branch of the superior laryngeal nerve also has a branch to in part efferently serve that cricopharyngeal part of the inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle. The other source of innervation for the larynx comes from the recurrent laryngeal nerves. Those recurrent laryngeal nerves are also branches of the vagus. On the right side, it wraps around the subclavian artery. On the left side, it wraps around the concavity of the aorta. On both sides, they head towards that tracheoesophageal groove to ascend towards the larynx. Now, some sources, once we move or ascend beyond that inferior margin of the cricoid cartilage, we'll refer to the recurrent laryngeal nerve as the inferior laryngeal nerve. Oops. Whether it's recurrent or inferior, it's the same nerve. But regardless, in these videos, we call it the recurrent laryngeal nerve. That recurrent laryngeal nerve is going to efferently serve all of the intrinsic laryngeal muscles except for the cricothyroid muscle, which is served by the external branch of the superior laryngeal nerve. It's also going to be afferent from the mucosa of the larynx below the vocal folds, and it will be secretomotor to those folds as well, or to the mucosa below those folds as well. In addition, recurrent laryngeal nerve has a branch that also efferently serves that cricopharyngeal part of inferior pharyngeal constrictor. So the external branch is superior laryngeal nerve, the recurrent laryngeal nerve, as well as the pharyngeal plexus, all will serve that cricopharyngeal part, which is pretty impressive in terms of overall innervation. And that leads us to our assessment question for the video, and that is, the inferior laryngeal artery is a branch of the inferior thyroid artery, which is sourced from which artery? Brachiocephalic trunk, that seems a little too general. External carotid, well, that's the superior thyroid, so that's wrong. Thyrocervical trunk, inferior thyroid artery is a branch of the thyrocervical trunk, so that's sounding good to me. And transverse cervical artery, but only 30% of the time. No, that's a distractor as well. So the correct answer is that the inferior laryngeal artery and inferior thyroid arteries are ultimately sourced from the thyrocervical trunk. Thank you very much for your time.